The unit is called Supporting Innovative Pedagogies with Digital Technologies, and it's a unit which is studied by early childhood, primary and secondary students. They're learning ways to incorporate digital technologies into their learning design. So they're thinking about ways to make students think and analyse data. They're thinking about ways in which students can communicate with remote experts using digital technologies. It's very much learn how to learn.
I sort of thought at the start that schools weren't the place for technology, like with little kids and younger kids, and that it didn't really have a place in education, but I'm actually starting to learn that it can be used like really effectively to enhance learning situations across a range of subjects, not just ICT, but it can actually improve creativity and engagement.
So technology is a big part of our lives, and so students at school need to learn about how to use that technology safely and appropriately, and to learn how to employ it in their own thinking and learning. And so for us, our teachers need to know how to use it well in their own practice, but also help students to learn how to use it well.
Something like stop motion is a great one, so you can get kids to actually make their own little example of what's going on with a problem-solving quiz in maths or in science. These are technologies I didn't get an opportunity to use when I was at school. It was back in 2008 and we're still using overhead projectors and all that, so it was quite cool seeing how far technology's advanced in the education system to sort of be able to engage students in different ways and enhance it and be more inclusive to everybody.
So the unit's for everybody. So we have some students who are very, very competent with technology. We have some students who have a very limited experience. But the unit's designed to allow them all to grow and to learn with each other. So one of the things we do is we get them to collaborate and learn collaboratively towards a creative outcome so they can stretch their abilities and deepen their knowledge.
My own knowledge of different technologies did not extend much past that, or just using my own phone and computer. So I've actually learnt a lot of different cool softwares that can be used for learning that I did not know existed. So that's been really helpful.
We're quite keen that students are able to develop the skills to teach themselves how to learn, because over 40 years, the skills that we teach them today are going to be outdated very quickly. So our whole emphasis is learn how to learn. And the way they do that is through the support of peers. Schools are very interested in getting graduates who can lead in this area, and that is where our graduates are getting the advantage, I think, because we are always encouraging them to look at a technology and look at the opportunity for how this can be used to develop a curricular concept.
I'll definitely take a lot of this forward and get them embedded, because I'd say as we go through the years, in the next 4 years, digital technology will be even more embedded into the classroom.